to Shane Gilgeous Alexander.
Welcome, everybody. Thanks for joining us for NBA action on 2K Sports. This is Kevin Harlan with Greg Anthony and Clark Kellogg and our sideline reporter, David Aldridge. DA, it's all yours.
Well, thank you, Kevin. Nikola Jokic has a signature move, a wrong foot fadeaway jumper dubbed the Sombor Shuffle after his hometown. Jokic said, "I twisted my left ankle and it was painful to jump off of both legs. I started jumping off the right leg and the ball was going in. And I said, maybe I can use this." Kevin, it's been working. Back to you.
It has been unstoppable. David, thank you. Can you believe it? Already, Clark, there's some trade chatter out there. And we've only played a handful of games.
Yeah, you know, Kevin, sometimes people want instant oatmeal. Sometimes you got to put that thing in the pot and stir it up for a little while. Social media has really ramped up the pace and size of expectations for players, coaches, front offices, and fans. Everybody's getting scrutinized because of social media. Pipe down, folks. Pipe down.
Now let's take a look at the Nuggets opening lineup. Out on the perimeter, it's Caldwell Pope and Porter Jr. Gordon steps in at the four with Jokic in at center. And it's Murray in at the point. And for the Thunder, outside the wings are Gilgeous Alexander and Dort. Then it's Williams. Then it's Josh Giddey. And it's Robinson Earl in at the five down low. Now here's Giddey. Here's Williams. And he banks in the layup.
An efficient start here offensively, working it inside for the easy two.
Jokic with a screen on Giddey. Murray. The Thunder pull it in. Now Williams passes to Giddey. Stolen by Caldwell Pope. To the inside and finished off by Porter.
Yeah, first and foremost, he's a pass-first team player, is Caldwell Pope. Love seeing that.
Caldwell Pope against Gilgeous Alexander. And just over a minute played here in the start of the game. Murray kicks to Caldwell Pope. Good ball movement here by the Nuggets. The kick out to Porter. Takes the three. A three-pointer is right on target. Porter's got 5 points so far.
And Porter Jr. feels like he can drain just about any shot, including these corner three balls.
And this Thunder team in desperate need of a veteran. Someone on their way out that can still be productive and provide some leadership for the young guys. And one step ahead of the defense with that solid screen.
And then, Greg, the monster dunk to finish it off.
Boy, picture-perfect teamwork that time, guys. One guy sacrificing for the other. That's how you succeed in this league.
So now, how does Oklahoma City, Greg, get back into the mix in the Western Conference?
Kevin, it's going to be tough. Just so much inexperience on the roster right now. Keeping the core here, yeah, but experienced players to fill out that roster.
Jokic, no good. Thunder have gone 2-3 here to start out the game. Gilgeous Alexander against Caldwell Pope. Gilgeous Alexander passes to Giddey. Tries again, and it's good on the way.
And once he got to the 10, I think he was surprised to find himself that wide open.
Well, this early, they should be showing a lot more energy on defense. It's not there.
Now here's Murray. The tray. Gilgeous Alexander trying to free himself up. And his third shot of the night, no good, 0-3. Robinson Earl, the pass to Gilgeous Alexander. The pass to Robinson Earl. Four on the shot clock. Here's Giddey. Lays it up and in on the nice reverse. Giddey's got his second basket of the night.
Beautiful reverse using his body to shield the finish. Nicely done.
And there's the call on Lou Dort. That is his first foul of the game.
First personal foul. First team foul.
Here's Murray. Pass to Jokic. And first quarter, we're about 3.5 minutes in. Down to 5 on the shot clock. From deep. It's rebounded by Oklahoma City.
A shot like that is a polite way to say, hey, coach, bench me.
Hey, that's crazy there. I mean, insanity. At least wait until you get across half court. My goodness.
And that was the Mobile One drive. Well worth a second look.
And putting that pressure on the rim. That's what it's all about, threatening with that attack.
This team has credited Giddey's background for shaping him as a player.
You know, he grew up in a house dominated by basketball. Both his parents played professionally in Australia, and that goes a long way toward developing your basketball idea.
Baisley's checked in for Kenrich Williams.
Thank you, City Crew. Give him a hand, fans.
And so here's Denver. It's a 5-point game. Here's Giddey. Pass to Gilgeous Alexander. Robinson Earl, the pass to Giddey. 5 to shoot. Oklahoma City needs to get off a shot. Here's Dort. And the shot is long. The Nuggets trail by 5. Passes it to Caldwell Pope. To the wing on the left. Giddey against Jokic. Over Giddey. They grab their own miss. The kick out to Porter. Dishes it to Murray. Hits it from 3-point range.
This is Murray's game. A shoot first combo guard who's ready to fire as soon as he has it.
The pass to Baisley. Outside, Gilgeous Alexander. Now, here's Dort. Back to Gilgeous Alexander. Pass to Baisley. The 10-footer. And a great assist by Gilgeous Alexander as that one goes in.
And this is Gilgeous Alexander's responsibility to find his guys when they're open.
Murray kicks to Caldwell Pope. And there's a minute 45 left in the first quarter of the game. Porter. That shot missing. So the Thunder will take it the other way. They come into this one having outplayed the Magic last game.
Well, it's easy to score when you're facing very little resistance. That's why their offense looks so good now.
Well, I think it was a combination of things, quite honestly, but the defense didn't really offer them a challenge all night. I agree with that.
Giddey, no good. The Nuggets trail by 4. Jokic passes to Murray. 1:11 left here in the first quarter. Gordon for 3. Thunder with the rebound. Last game against the Nuggets, they lost in the Mile High City.
And their last time playing this club, foul trouble became a big problem for them. Their starters had to take an early stint on the bench.
They've just got to be more careful tonight. It's that simple. I mean, those guys are too valuable. They need them on the floor.
Now, Giddey. Following the 3-point attempt by Aaron Gordon. Giddey with it, and it's Gordon picking him up. Offensive rebound. Denver's gotten just 2 of 6 to fall from 3-point range so far in the first. Here's Murray. Misses off the right iron.
Well, you have to like their work on the boards, Kevin, particularly here to start the game.
Yeah, I like the way they're setting the tone, really playing with a lot of energy here at the start.
Now here's Murray. After the miss from Shai Gilgeous-Alexander. Murray surveying the D. Caldwell Pope with a screen for Murray. Here's Jokic. Beat the shot clock, but it's off the mark. And so the first quarter is in the books. Thunder lead by four. And we'll be back with you for the start of the second quarter when we return. Just joining us, we've played through one quarter of action so far. What stands out to you from Oklahoma City in this one?
Well, when you control the glass, you control the second chance opportunities on both ends.
And, you know, their rebounding advantage has been glaring, simply outworking them on the boards for that entire first quarter.
The Nuggets trail by four. They've got Chang. Williams is out there with Mike Muscala. And it's Pokuševski in at the four. That's the lineup out there for the Thunder. Brown with a screen on Williams. Here's Highland. And he uses the glass on the layup. Highland's got his first basket of the night.
Great job of screening there. Nice job to take it to the rim and get the finish.
Here's Mann. And the layup's good off the glass. And the Thunder lead by four.
And they keep hammering away at them inside, forcing the ball into the paint.
Highland passes to Smith. They kick it out to Green. Here's Highland. He's guarded by Williams. In the corner, Smith with it. That one wide left.
The game has been very close in a lot of areas, but rebounding has been the one differentiator thus far.
We've seen it time and time again in games. Effort and determination on the glass can make up for a lot of other weaknesses.
No clue how he got that one to fall.
And that was not a soft foul he had to get through. I mean, he had to really power that one up and in.
At the line for your Oklahoma City, Mike Muscala. At the line for one.
That's good for Muscala. In decades past, teams that led the league in threes, if they shot that same rate now, would rank Greg dead last in the NBA. So with that thought, which teams of yesteryear probably should have shot more threes?
And that's a good one. Kevin, I think you got to look back to the Run TMC Warriors, right? How about the Larry Bird Celtics? Man, they could knock down the triple.
Here's Williams. The Nuggets getting the bucket.
First personal foul, second team foul.
Second quarter of basketball, just over a minute and a half played. Here's Mann, covered by Smith. Mann can't hit. And so it's Smith with it. He'll bring it up for the Nuggets. Trailing by five. Here's Highland. Jacks up a three. Rebound by Muscala. And the short break in the action gives us a chance now to send it over to David Aldrin.
Thank you, Kevin. Now, Michael Porter Jr. was a top prospect in his high school class, but his back injury has presented a constant challenge. He says, it changed my perspective. I'm just going to get up every day and try to be better than I was the day before. If I'm giving my best every day, I'm good. Back to you guys.
Well, you hope he stays healthy. That has been a concern. Thanks, David.
Wow, he got whacked on that one. Shouldn't be much debate there.
Blatant contact. Straightforward call. Simple.
And some stats here, guys. The scoring breakdown for the Thunder.
Everything working for them inside so far, guys. Tons of high-quality shots that they're knocking down inside.
And I also have to bring up their passing game. They've been moving the ball with great precision so far and creating great looks for their teammates.
And the first one at the line is good. I think it's pretty clear, Greg, what the goal is for this Denver organization long term.
It's simple, Kevin. Make it to the finals. The Nuggets have never been there. They've been close reaching a conference finals on more than one occasion.
Both shots good from the stripe.
And such a young, exciting core for the Nuggets. The MVP, Jokic, Michael Porter Jr., and Jamal Murray. This group has a chance to be a contender for years to come.
Akusevski, the best of man. Williams with the ball. Now Green defending. A shot by Williams, no good.
He has to make that one. I mean, you have to make the defense pay when they slough off of you like that.
Brown the pass to Najee. Here's Green. Pass to Najee. Just four to shoot. Here's Brown with the three. The Nuggets with another miss. With Jokic, I mean, the potential break, this Denver team, they've got so much. But what is the key for them to actually reach it?
Kevin, simply health. I mean, they need Murray and MPJ to be out there. Those two have had major injury issues. Jokic is a generational talent, but the man needs help.
I'm not sure whose fault that was, guys, but they need to get on the same page here.
Wiggins is checked in for the Thunder. The Nuggets trail by five. Smith outside. To the middle. Doesn't get it to drop for him. And it's Oklahoma City the other way. Closing in on 4 minutes played here in the second quarter. The 11-footer. Williams shot is off. Nuggets have gone 2 of 6 from the field in the second quarter so far. Here's Highland. And here's Green outside. Wiggins with the rebound. Kicks it to Muscala. And that'll be two free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul.
Second personal foul. 13 foul.
And this is his second trip to the line in the game.
Mike Muscala at the line for two.
And the first one drops. You know, one thing, Greg, the Thunder have done a great job of drafting international players.
Players like Serge Ibaka, Steven Adams in the past, a few good ones on this current roster as well. Credit the OKC scouts for just finding guys all over the world.
So Denver ends up going with a whole new group. And Muscala drops them both.
And didn't have a single free throw in that first quarter, but he started to play with a little bit more of an edge to his game here in the second.
And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Mike Muscala. That'll be his second foul of the game.
Picking up his second foul here. Has to be careful because they can pile up quickly.
And Oklahoma City making a change. Dort's checked in. Now here's Murray. He had a 21-point outing in their last game against the Lakers in Los Angeles. Jokic, and Jokic throws it down hard.
Look, this package that Jokic has, instinct, length, timing, you don't have to jump really high if you've got those things working for you to be effective as a rebound.
Awesome rewind courtesy of the AT&T 5G Slam Cam. And it's the Thunder with the ball. The Nuggets getting the bucket. Gilgeous Alexander can't get it to go. The Nuggets trail by five. Outside, Porter. He kicks it to Gordon. Murray for three. No good that time. Now, Oklahoma City takes it the other way.
and the rebound battle split evenly thus far.
Yeah, tit for tat on the glass. Just one more aspect of what's been a very closely contested ball game here.
Now, here's Gilgeous Alexander. He had 34 points in the win against Orlando.
And what opened things up for him was his passing. He was making so many plays that the D had to play off it. And that's the kind of lead pass we've come to expect from him.
Murray outside. 1:31 left to play in the first half.
He is just really almost playing for the other team. The shooting has just been poor.
Giddy the pass to Gilgeous Alexander. This is it to Baisley. And here is Giddy. Releases from 15. That one off the back iron and out. The Nuggets trail by 7.
And a chance to check out some stats for Gordon. Good season for him last year. Averaged 15 points a game, 6 rebounds, and 2 assists. And you talk about guys who just have a nose for putting up points. He is one of them.
Yeah, he sure is. And he rarely has back-to-back bad games. If he has an off night, he usually follows that up with a big night.
Now, here's Gilgeous Alexander. 7-point game, the biggest lead in the game. Buries it from about 10 feet away. Gilgeous Alexander's got his 2nd basket of the night.
Largely because of that win, Gilgeous Alexander feeling confident attacking inside.
Murray the pass to Jokic. Murray outside. Baseline jumper. And it's Jokic missing. Oklahoma City leading by 9. Gilgeous Alexander surveying the D. Was able to put it up in time, but doesn't fall. And so it's the Oklahoma City Thunder. Ahead by 9 as the quarter comes to a close. They're pounding the ball inside, and that's where they've gotten their best production tonight. And now let's catch up with David Aldridge, who's standing by from the sideline. All right, Dave.
Thanks a lot, guys. With Mike Malone, as the second half approaches, Coach, what are you looking for?
Execution, pace and purpose with everything that we do, and making sure that when we call a set, we know what we're trying to accomplish and get the ball to where our players can be effective.
We'll see if they can fix that in the second half. Thanks, Coach. Back to you.
Thank you, David. And we'll be back after halftime as the third quarter gets underway.
Thanks for joining us, everyone. Let's first take a gander at the rest of the NBA schedule for the night and what's in store. It'll be the Golden State Warriors up against the Magic in Orlando. That one tips off at 7 p.m. Eastern.
Obviously, both clubs want to make ground up in these standings.
Easier said than done for these teams. They face some obstacles.
And now, coming back to this game, a strong first half for the Thunder.
Coach has to be loving the all-around production. Each guy carrying his weight. That's a luxury to have, and it's fun to watch.
Yeah, total team effort tonight. Thank you for being with us. Now let's send it to Kevin Harlan for the second half tip.
If your chip is in the books, one half to go. And so it's Murray who brings the ball up for the Denver Nuggets. 9-point game. Taking a look at the Nuggets. Murray and Caldwell Pope, the guard. The forward spots will be Porter Jr. and Gordon. And it's Jokic in at the center position. Now here's Murray. Caldwell Pope with a screen for Murray. Shoots over Gilgeous Alexander. Shot clock at 2. Caldwell Pope. It's rebounded by Giddy. Giddy's got 4 rebounds in this game. Gilgeous Alexander, a screen on Porter. Giddy finds Gilgeous Alexander. That one goes in. Gilgeous Alexander's got the lead up to 11 now for Oklahoma City.
Unwilling to let up, even for a moment. That's his killer instinct, just fanning the flame.
Yeah, I love the fact he doesn't play the score. He just keeps coming, attack mode. He doesn't know how to step off the gas pedal.
Over in the corner, Caldwell Pope. Drills it from outside. Caldwell Pope's got his first bucket of the game, and he's on the board for three.
And back in 2021, Nikola Jokic became the lowest drafted player to ever win the MVP. The 41st pick of the draft, the first second round pick to win the award. No other way to put it, just a poor shooting performance for him. But luckily, his teammates have picked up the slack.
And with that, the Thunder lead is cut down to just 6 points on the bucket from Gordon.
Boy, I like seeing Gordon work on that jump shot of his. He's going to need to knock it down consistently at his position to be one of the best in the league.
And from second rounder to MVP grade, Nikola Jokic. What a story.
Amazing, Kevin. And you know, one thing the Joker did to transform his game, dedicate himself to his conditioning. Jokic is in much better shape now than when he first entered the league. That's not the type of opportunity he fails to convert very often.
Murray kicks to Caldwell Pope. Gordon for three. And the rebound goes to the Thunder. Here's Robinson Earl. Outside, Dort. Now here's Giddy. Here's the pass to Robinson Earl. A three-pointer, no good.
And they're 1-4 here to start the second half.
Jokic passes to Murray. Jokic a screen. Murray, no good.
You know, he's just not taking good shots, not taking smart shots, forcing up a lot of low percentage jump there.
Gilgeous Alexander with it. 6 points for him. Over Caldwell Pope. Gilgeous Alexander, good. Gilgeous Alexander's got 8 points.
With great positional size, Gilgeous Alexander can finish over defenders.
Time called here. The Nuggets decide to talk it over. And Oklahoma City going with a whole new group out there.
A chance now to see the numbers. Some last season stats for him. Averaged about 9 points a game last year. 4 rebounds and 2 assists. The contributions he's been making on the floor have been a boon for this team. Great stretch of games for him.
Yeah, you know, they've given him more responsibility, and he's responded. And the way he's going, I think his role is only going to increase.
Pass to Pokuševski. A three ball. Sinks the triple. Pokuševski's got himself on the board with 3 there.
And an eye for an eye. Both teams working to stretch the floor.
Nothing like answering back. One team gets 3, you fire 3 of your own. Boom.
Here's Highland. He has 5. From deep. And with the rebound.
Yeah, just a solid job on the backboard. They are really controlling the inside.
Well, they're working the glass, really battling in that area of the game. And that's helped them stake this lead.
Feeds it to Muscala. Shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot 2 free throws.
And really the defense fouling there to prevent the layup, but that's exactly what you need to do.
It is. I mean, no reason to back off and give him the layup. Much better off making him go to the line.
And Muscala drops them both. Clark, how about the Nuggets? This core has really delivered.
Yeah, I like the young nucleus there, Kevin, led by the Joker, Nikola Jokic. I mean, one of the best in the West. I think they've built a perennial contender. Definitely back on the map and in the thick of things. Got to get Porter Jr. and Murray healthy.
Time now to turn to our sideline reporter, David Aldridge. David.
Thanks, guys. Well, the Thunder are trying to build something that will last. The front office says you stick to your principles, your values, and you think long-term. We're focused on building a sustainably great team. We continue to be forward-facing in that respect. Kevin, back to you.
It's a good philosophy, and they're not looking for any shortcuts, which is admirable. David, thanks. Now here's Chang, still getting warmed up offensively. No scoring yet from him. Laid in with a nice touch off the glass. Chang's got the lead up to 12 now for the Thunder.
Pretty much all of their buckets coming from inside the paint now.
Green, the screen. They need this. It's tipped, and he recovers it. Brown outside. Tries yet again. He can't get that one to fall. And the Thunder going the other way now.
It's a plus five advantage for them in rebounding after
two
that.
2 minutes remaining in the third. 2 minutes.
Baisley passes to Mann. Here's Baisley. Fires from deep. Hyland with the rebound. 1:43 left in the third quarter. And again, Denver no good.
No doubt it's been a bit of a struggle for him here in this quarter in terms of scoring.
Here's Chang, and finished off by Chang.
Taking it to the rack with power,
hammering down the two-hand slam.
Really piling on the lead with a dunk like that.
Now here is Smith. He's still scoreless so far in this one. They set the pick. And the call on the shot that sends him to the line.
And you know, Smith, the former Demon Deacon, he's a savvy veteran whose passing and shooting really can frustrate opponents.
No good on the free throw. Jokic has checked in for Najee. He hits the second from the line. Thunder leading by 13. Pass to Mann. And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line.
And the defender all over.
He got it good there. I mean, that's why the shot was so far
off. All right, well, look at how the points have been generated so far. Scoring breakdown for the Thunder.
You know, all game long, they've imposed their will on the interior, scoring a lot of points in the painted area.
And we also got to talk about the damage they've done inside. The opposition having a hard time keeping that ball out of the paint.
And so he hits both.
Impeccable from the line since halftime.
No misses yet. You can't do much better than that, guys.
Jokic kicks to Brown. A floater. That's in. Coming off the assist from Jokic. Jokic has got his fourth assist in this one. Passes it to Pokusevski. Here's the screen. Back to Chang. Just five on the clock. Here's Mann. The Thunder with another miss.
The shot's there for him, and he's got to take it. I don't care if he doesn't convert. That's a shot he has to continue to take.
Elite at moving the ball. Jokic is one of the best passers in the league, regardless of position. No doubt, he's the best five-man passer for sure.
Mann can't hit. Here's Hyland. The three. And so it's the Oklahoma City Thunder holding on to an 11-point cushion as we get ready to take a break. And it's been their rugged defense setting the tone. Back right after this. Moments ago from the huddle, let's listen in to Michael Malone.
Stay positive. Don't get down. We got a lot of time left. We're going to win the game. We are going to win the game.
Coach Mike Malone moments ago trying to get each guy to believe in himself, believe that this still can happen.
And the players have to trust each other. It's going to take all five guys working together to recapture that momentum.
And there may not be a lot of drama down the stretch as we head into the fourth quarter, but stranger things have happened. Giddy and Gilgeous Alexander are the guards. We'll see Dort and Baisley playing it forward. And it's Robinson Earl in at the pivot spot, manning the middle. That's the lineup out there for the Thunder.
He is single-handedly dropping the temperature in here with that cold streak.
And he's got to find other ways to contribute then, because his shot-making is not happening right now.
And here is Giddy. There's a screen. 11 feet away, and too long on the shot.
You know, even though they're on top in this one, you'd like him to be better out there because he's capable of being better. It sure would make things a lot easier, too.
Now here's Murray. Porter finds Caldwell Pope. Kept alive, Jokic. And the lead is down inside single digits.
And defensively, they are on their heels every time the ball comes inside.
Yeah, I think they've got to ramp up the aggressiveness. If they don't, things are just going to get worse from here.
Giddy against Murray. And Giddy gets it to go. And the Thunder lead by 11.
When you allow good scorers to get uncontested shots at the rim, no wonder you're losing.
You know, he should be getting extra attention from the defense, not less.
Jokic kicks to Porter. Back to Jokic. Over in the corner, Caldwell Pope. And the three off target.
And I thought that was going to drop. It looked good from here.
Here's Baisley. He's covered by Murray. Gilgeous Alexander, a screen on Gordon. Giddy, no good. The Nuggets trail by 11. Caldwell Pope right side. Kicks it to Murray. Count it from 12.
Jamal Murray.
Murray using the mid-range, an effective shot for a good penetrator like Jamal. He's a natural scorer.
Now a timeout called by Oklahoma City. Williams is checked in for Baisley. And now the latest from our reporter, David Aldridge.
During that last break, Coach Mark Daigneault talked to his team. He told them, this is a game of runs. It's a game of momentum. You may have the lead now, but I'm telling you guys, it can evaporate in a hurry. Let's close this thing out. Kevin?
Thank you, David. Now, here's Gilgeous Alexander. That's good from Williams on the assist by Gilgeous Alexander.
Continues to develop his playmaking abilities. Gilgeous Alexander is an unselfish team player.
Murray against Giddy. They get it again. It's good, and the Thunder lead is cut down to 9 in the bucket from Jokic.
Well, I love the way he goes after it there. I mean, you've got to respect that. He's rewarded for his efforts of pursuing the ball.
Now, Gilgeous Alexander. There's a good screen. The leaner. And he gets the whistle. Two free throws coming up. It's going to be on Jokic.
And this young man, a rising scorer who continues to improve. Gilgeous Alexander may soon be the focal point of every opponent's scouting report.
He misses the free throw. And Greg Anthony for Shai Gilgeous-Alexander, part of a growing trend in this NBA, giving his team length in the backcourt.
Yeah, 6'6 with a 6'11 wingspan. He can see over the top of the defense. He helps you on the glass, and he can switch onto front court players defensively. That's what teams are looking for nowadays.
And that trip coming up empty, missing both.
And lost his touch right there. Didn't see that coming. Usually, when he's hot, he stays hot.
I think it's important that Caldwell Pope makes these shots, showing real toughness, converting through contact.
Here's Giddy. Following the basket by Kentavious Caldwell Pope. Outside, Gilgeous Alexander. Here's Williams, and finished off by Williams.
The D just kind of stepping aside and letting him get to the rim.
There's a reason, GA, the lead is what it is right now.
You know, you look at it, the communication is lacking, as is the trust. They can ill afford those types of breakdowns. It won't work. You can't win with those kind of breakdowns.
And the basket by Gordon.
Yeah, and they are living and dying from beyond the arc since halftime. It's a different look than what we saw in the first half.
Now, here's Gilgeous Alexander. Here's Robinson Earl. Inside, here's Giddy. Rebound by the Nuggets. Jokic has got 14, yep, 14 rebounds for him tonight. Wow. Murray outside. And with that, the Thunder lead is cut down now to just four in the basket from Jokic.
Easy to understand why they turn to Jokic in these situations. He has a knack for cashing in on big possession.
Now here's Giddy. Trying to break that ice-cold streak, and he lays it up and in. And the Thunder lead by six.
Just reliable, guys. He's just always trying to make the right play.
Caldwell Pope with the screen on Giddy. Here's Jokic. Whistle blows. Basket is good. So a chance here for a three-point play.
Jokic doing a really good job that time, concentrating and maintaining his balance despite being fouled.
Free throw, good. Jokic.
Getting it done at the line as he usually does. And that could be huge in a tight game like this one.
Now a timeout called by Oklahoma City. They lead by three. 1:49 left here in the fourth quarter. .46 left to play in the final quarter. Here's Gilgeous Alexander, and it's Denver with the rebound. Porter's got his fourth rebound in this one. In the corner, it's Gordon. There's the drive, and it's Gordon with the finish.
Fantastic execution in a tight spot. Gordon capitalizing in the big moment for his team.
On our AT&T 5G Slam Cam, you just saw an explosive highlight. Now, here's Gilgeous Alexander. From deep three-point range, Jokic craps the miss.
And that was a little bit of a range check for him.
You know, guys, I think he's got confidence to shoot it from anywhere, but he could have gotten a better one than that. This dude, folks, has ice in his veins when the game is tight. Kentavious Caldwell Pope.
Gilgeous Alexander. Two free throws coming up, and they call the shooting foul.
All the officials are all over that one.
Clearly a foul. I mean, didn't give him any choice but to blow the whistle. You got to play without fouls.
And a chance to catch up on some numbers here. Scoring breakdown for the Nuggets.
Well, you know, they've been tremendous, I think, when it comes to sharing the basketball. Shoot, you know, getting guys involved on the plays and creating offensive opportunities for everybody. Equal opportunity offense is fun to watch.
And just a great job converting those second chance points as well. They're having a great night getting those second and third shot opportunities.
And so making both free throws, that'll give them the lead here.
And nice work at the line. I mean, when the game's this close, you have got to cash in on those opportunities.
Caldwell Pope with the screen on Giddy. Now, here's Jokic. Defense right on him. Here's Porter. The Thunder pull it in. The biggest lead of the game, 15 points. Dort passes to Gilgeous-Alexander. There's the screen. And Jokic with the rebound.
Not sure if he just ran out of gas or what. He's been awful ever since the second half started. Not even been a factor.
It's 9 seconds separating the shot clock and game. And that's going to be too many steps. It's the whistle on the travel.
And those are the kinds of mistakes that are magnified when you're talking about a game down the stretch.
And so they choose to intentionally foul.
And you know what? Smart foul. You got to try and extend the game.
It's not over. Clock is as much a problem for them as the score is right now, so they got to try to manage it.
Shane Gilgeous-Alexander taking two shots.
So the first one drops, and that will put them up by two.
And we've seen SGA blossom into a number one option. Another chance here to prove himself.
Second one is good. We both at the line. It's a three-point game.
Yeah, those free throws make things a little more simpler right now. They just have to guard against the three-pointer.
Time called here. The Nuggets decide to talk it over. They're trailing by three. There's 18 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Guys, what do you think?
And if you can get a three, shoot it. Otherwise, get the quick two and a foul.
Either way, they got to score the ball.
Turn it up, Thunderbirds. We need 18.4 seconds.
There's 18 seconds left to play here in the fourth. Murray, the pass to Jokic. The Nuggets with another miss. And they stop the clock as soon as they can with the intentional foul.
Third personal foul, 14 foul. At the line for your Thunder,
Shane Gilgeous-Alexander. Two shots.
Shoot two.
Gets the first, and that gives them a four-point cushion. And so both free throws are good. It's a five-point game.
And that's the knockout blow right there, guys. Those free throws should put this one away.
Denver calls timeout. They're behind by five. 9 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Guys, your thoughts?
They're trying to get back in this thing. They need a score.
Yeah, and they need it hiccup fast. I mean, they'll be drawing up a quick hitter in the huddle here, no doubt.
There's Porter with the three. It's money from deep.
Just refusing to back down when the spotlight's brightest. Porter outstanding at taking over here in the clutch.
Now a timeout called by Oklahoma City. They're leading by two. 6 seconds left in the game. In the fourth. And an intentional foul there stops the clock.
First personal foul. 15 foul. At the line for your Oklahoma City, Josh Giddey taking two shots.
Good on the first, and that makes it a 3-point lead. and he hits both free throws here. So now it's a four-point ball game. 6 seconds left in the fourth quarter of this one. Caldwell Pope for three. So a close game sees Oklahoma City taking this one. They didn't make it easy on themselves or their fans, but in the end, everyone's satisfied.
I mean, there were some times that momentum shifted, and especially early on, but let's give this group a lot of credit for that stick-to-itiveness in terms of finishing out and executing that game plan.
And now, let's check in with David Aldridge reporting from the sideline for our player of the game. David, take it away.
Thanks very much, Shea. Balanced scoring for you all tonight. What is working offensively?
Yeah, we're just trusting each other, playing for each other, doing the sets that Coach has us doing, and really just being unselfish. When you do those things like that happen.
It was a great performance all around tonight. Congrats on the win again. Back to you.
Thank you, David. Great interview once again. Thank you for joining us. That'll do it for now. For David Aldridge, Greg Anthony, and Clark Kellogg, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for being with us. As we leave you with our New Balance Player of the Game, Shea Gilgeous-Alexander.